So I completed the challenge, but I thought people might be interested in what other games I played this year. I'm planning to do more RPGs next year, so it's probably not worth doing Sky Verilog as much. But I thought I would do an Encore mode for the rest of 2023. And so it is Saturday, October 14th, and game number 53 is Silent Hill on the PlayStation. So I don't own a PlayStation, but I do have a PlayStation Classic. And it's very easy just to use a memory stick to have it be on a sorry, my youngest has just gone to bed and apparently he's unhappy about that fact. Sorry. So yeah, PlayStation Classic has been hacked with a memory stick and I've added in Silent Hill. I have never played this game before, but as it's October and it's spooky season, I thought I would give it a go. And yeah, I'm honestly very impressed by it. Yes, I accept that it's PlayStation graphics and this is tank controls, which at times did frustrate me, along with the camera angles you sometimes had to put up with. But even with that, I still think, for the PlayStation era, this is like a masterpiece title, and I can see why it spawned the series it has. So it's just like, even from like the intro video, it just sets the tone for the game perfectly. And then once you're in it, it's like, because I love Resident Evil as well, and the two usually come up in conversation together, like survival horror and all that. But whereas Resident Evil is definitely more action orientated, this is more like actual survival, like more horror, kind of like trying to survive in the environment. And the way it handles like the real world and like the dark world or whatever, yeah, it's just this is a masterclass in how to actually set a horror tone and atmosphere for a game. So if you haven't played it, honestly, go and play it. Do it. Just go and play it. It's a fantastic game, and at some point I'll play the second, which is some people's like favorite game of all time. So yeah, Silent Hill on the PlayStation. So it is Tuesday the 21st of November and game 54 is beaten and that is Doom for the PC. So yeah, it's been a hot minute since I completed Silent Hill and yeah, okay, technically I beat Streets of Rage 2, but because Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Shredder's Re-Revenge is just a reskin of like the characters from Streets of Rage 2 to be Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, I'm not counting Streets of Rage 2 because it's technically the same game. Yeah, so I have actually been playing this for the last month with a friend of mine remotely, like doing Steam remote play. So in other words, that Steam lets someone else, as long as the game's, I say the game, long as the game has co-op, Steam will stream your game to them and then they can have like second player input, for example. They've used it with a bunch of games and we've done it for like other, like Streets of Rage 4 or sorry, Final Vendetta. But yeah, so Doom. Doom is a game I've talked about before on my channel. And this is original 1993 Doom, not 2016 Doom. But yeah, so we were playing through all four episodes. Yeah, it's a game that is like a landmark genre-defining, genre-creating kind of game. So yeah, enjoyed it. It was good to like, it was some interesting level design back then, shall we say. But yeah, it's a game that pretty much runs with everything and pretty much everyone owns. So give Doom a try, as easily accessible and fun to play with, and it's enjoyable with co-op. So you might be running around trying to figure out what the hell to do next when there's a secret door you can't find. It happens a couple of times. But yes, Doom. It's Doom. What more can I say? It is Thursday, November 30th, and just finished game 55, and that is Mirror's Edge Catalyst on the PC. So it's a game I've actually been looking forward to play for a while, because I loved the original. I know that it was, like, it had its flaws, but I just loved, like, you know, what it was trying to do, and the setting, and the music, and yeah, and it wasn't too long, so it didn't overstay its welcome, and that's probably why maybe I have so many fond memories of it, is that I didn't get sick of it. So, on December 8th, which by the time this goes out, that will be already gone. So the EA are shutting down the servers, so there's two achievements that can only be done via online. And I'm not exactly the person who goes for 100%, but if I enjoyed this game enough that I wanted to try and get 100% achievements, then I'd be like, ugh. So I decided to, you know, play the game finally, because I've owned it for like several years, but I just never got around to it, because it's kind of like an open world game. So anyway, so I decided to find play it, and what do I think of it? Flawed, definitely flawed. I enjoyed it. When you're doing well at the parkour and you're just going, it just feels good. But there's things that really do let it down. So the first game had some shooting. That this does not have that at all, but it still has melee combat. And if you don't actually bother getting good at the melee combat, then there is a mission where you literally cannot proceed until, you know, the story missions, you cannot proceed until you get past a melee encounter where they do throw loads of people at you, not at once, but like staggered, but still. And so if you haven't got good by then good luck. In the end, I had to quit that mission and then get another upgrade point, because there's an upgrade tree, of course there is, so to get me another health bit, so that I could then actually, don't get me wrong, this did also force me to understand the combat better, so in a way that probably helped for the rest of the game. It's just that up to this point, combat wasn't that difficult, and this kind of just intensified it. What else? So I'm not going for 100% achievement, because there's a bunch of side missions, which in its own probably wouldn't be that bad. It's just they are all pretty much timed, and there is like no margin of error. Like, if I complete them, it's usually with 1 or 2 seconds spare, and I just haven't got the time just to keep like doing these missions over again just for like additional achievements. And I'm doing this on Steam, so it's not like, you know, it's a platinum. It's just, oh, you get a thing that says, oh, you got 100% on that game, and that's it. So I'm not gonna put my time into it, and yeah, it's just frustrating at times to do it. Like, also the how Faith, the main character she controls, is also can be quite frustrating at times. Like, to do like some of these side missions, you have to have such precise control, but controlling, like, I was playing with a controller, and it's a first person game, and there's the times when it just didn't do what I wanted, because either the angle wasn't right or whatever. And yeah, anyway, I mean, I enjoy my time with it, but there are several times where I'm just like, fuck this, because of, like, you know, I just couldn't get past, you know, a certain side mission. Luckily, you have to complete those to continue, and the ones that kind of, like, you really should do, because they enable fast travel, those, there's no time limit, and it's more like, oh, can you get from here to there, you know, so it's not as difficult as, you've got to complete this delivery in 30 seconds, and it's just, like, great. But one thing that I actually quite liked about playing this was that I've had this for quite a while now, and this is a Steam Link. You can't buy these anymore, well, at least not from Valve themselves. You might be able to get them secondhand, but it's pretty much a streaming box. So it has Ethernet socket, power, HDMI, it has Wi-Fi, but I'm not going to trust Wi-Fi, and 3 USB sockets. And what I did was I actually streamed from my computer to the TV in the lounge and played that way, as if, you know, like how the modern people do it, with like modern consoles, I mean, even though I don't have a modern console. The reason I haven't used it for so long is just that I've just got used to just playing at the computer, but for a game that seems like it would be good for like sitting on the sofa, I was like, okay, yeah, we'll give it a try. And Valve still support it, as in, like, there was 35 updates waiting to be installed, because I haven't plugged it in for years, so, but yeah. So I'm going to try and play a few more this way, and yeah, rather than just being sat here, you know, give it a go. I mean, you can technically do keyboard and mouse through this, but I say technically as in it fully supports it, it's just the idea of, like, sets, you know, like, with the big TV. Anyway. Game 55 done. Maybe do some more this year? So, it is Thursday, the 7th of December, and just finished game 56, which is Devil Kings for the PS2. So, this game is the current Club 52 challenge game, picked by, I believe, Eddie Rollercorex, and that is Devil Kings, a game I'd never heard before, but if you play it, it's clearly, you know, using the same engine as, like, Devil May Cry. It's an interesting game. I've never played this genre before, but it's like, I always forget what the name of the series is that I always think of when seeing this kind of game. But, Dynasty Warriors, that's it, Dynasty Warriors. I don't know if there's a genre for it, but it's like beat 'em up, but, you know, more extreme? Anyway, so there's a bunch of different generals that you can play as. You pick one and play through a conquest. So it doesn't take that long to beat one of them. I played as the titular Devil King. And, yeah, it's nice. It's a bit repetitive, though. As you level up, you can unlock more stuff, and that's probably where, you know, maybe more the interesting stuff will happen. I think it, like, different moves and things, maybe. Otherwise, I unlocked a second move after I beat the main campaign, as in, like, I leveled up enough to get a second move. Otherwise, I was just doing one or two different things over and over and over and over again. So, it's not a bad game, it's just, and maybe if I play as some of the other generals, maybe it would be give me more variety, but to be honest, after beating it with one, I felt like I'd seen enough, and I got the credit screen, so I was happy. So, I mean, yeah, it's a game, because I don't own a PS2, so I had to emulate it, but it was interesting. So I don't know how much it goes for, so I can't really say if it's worth the cost, but it just depends if you like Dynasty Warriors, and maybe Dynasty Warriors does this better. Anyway, Devil Kings for the PS2, an interesting game, so till next time. So it is Friday, December 8th, and game 57 is beaten, and that is Blast Arena for the Master System. This is a homebrew game. It's not very long, only 10 levels. This one I found thanks to Revo on who does, like, a lot of homebrew stuff and shares a lot of homebrew things. And yeah, it's sorry, I can't remember the name of the person who made it. I've done a video where I've shown the gameplay of this. I didn't complete the game in that video, but I have since. And yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's, like I say, it's not very long. You can complete it to, like, 10 minutes of ish if you know what you're doing. Like, there's not necessarily a lot to it, but you still have to be good at, like, a shooter game, you know. And yeah, I think it's definitely worth checking out, and I wish this was actually, like, turned into, like, a bigger game, like, more to it, and hopefully it will do. But as this all is and does not say anything about a demo, then it's gonna be counted. So, Blast Arena for the Master System. Give it a try, it's definitely worth it. It is Sunday, December 24th, and game 58 is finished, and that is It Takes Two on the PS5. I don't have a PS5, but my friend does, and it's a co-op game, so we've been playing it together on his. He's already completed it before, but it's my first time playing through it, and I was honestly very impressed by it. I think this might be one of the best co-op games of all time. Like, a game that's actually designed, you know, ground up co-op, not single player at all in any way, shape or form, because don't get me wrong, there are great co-op games, but they also have single player. You play a single player, and it works perfectly fine on its own. Whereas this, just ground up co-op. That's it. I mean, you can also do it over the internet, but I don't think there is any way to play it on your own. I don't think. But anyway, the idea of the game is that you're playing as a couple who are about to get divorced, and their daughter, who doesn't really like the situation, tries to, you know, use the Book of Love to get them to try and sort out their relationship, but the book is magical and pulls them into like two dolls that the child has, and then you have to go through and turn back into being humans again. So yeah, I thought it was a fantastic game. It went on a lot longer than I was expecting. It took about, I think, 8 hours to complete. But yeah, if you're looking for a good co-op game, this is an easy, easy, easy recommend, and it's available pretty much on all like modern platforms, so give it a go. So, 2023 is over. I've beaten the 52 game challenge. But what now? What do I do for 2024?